Here we have something I've shot not too while ago, before the whole corona outbreak. We shot this at the beach in San Diego with the model Summer. I'm gonna post the link for you guys so you can take a look. And I am using the practical surrounding to complement colors of this model, and I'm gonna show you exactly what I mean. So here's our clip. Of course, not the whole thing got on the video, but we can see the model wearing yellow and she got a very nice red purse. The first thing we need to do is to balance our shot, okay? So I'm going to create a new node, Alt S, and right away I'm gonna create it into parallel, Alt B. Okay, as you can see, it's a pocket 4K camera. The first note is going to be saturation. And in the saturation tab, I'm simply going to increase saturation. So we're working with a nice image. Now, second one, I'm gonna call contrast. And in the contrast, I am simply going to bring everything down just like this. That way we have very nice basic image going on for us. And as you can see, it looks really good. So where's the whole complementary color thing comes in? We're gonna use right now natural environment to match everything. That way everything looks like a commercial. So here, let me adjust this. Here everything looks good. I'm gonna create a new node. And we're gonna start matching the whole thing. I'm gonna convert this again into parallel. First thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna call this one wall. And I'm gonna be working with the wall over here. So I'm gonna go into the costume and here I'm gonna do hue versus saturation. So I'm gonna point over here and I'm gonna pop a little bit of saturation. That way it looks nice and saturated. We're gonna feather it down. Now, I can keep this color or I can modify it a little bit. It's up to you. As of right now, everything looks perfect, so this would be editorial choice. If you want to do editorial choice, go hue versus hue. Again, tap it on the blue, and we can start altering the image. We can have more strong contrast, or we can have a little bit more teal kind of look of it. That way it works nicely with our 70s theme. There was a lot of teal and sort of orangey in the 70s. So that looks great. Let's toggle this before and after. We can see huge difference. Now our model looks fantastic. Her purse looks great. Now let's focus on this giant ball or whatever this thing is. So I'm gonna call this one ball. Okay. And with this, we can do a few things. I want to get cleanest possible selection. So I'm going to go into the window and I'm simply going to select circular mask. I'm just going to drop it over here. We're going to make it smaller a little bit. Okay, just like this. Let's make sure everything falls into it. Let's go to the tracker. We don't have any perspective. We don't have any rotation. We don't have any zoom. So let's do basic. Do not track more than you should, because when you're tracking more than you're supposed to, you give computer extra information to kind of confuse it. So don't do this if you don't have to. Okay, so let's track forward now. Okay, looks great. All right, perfect. So let's see our selection. We have the ball. Everything looks great. Now, in this selection, let's go to the qualifier and tap it on the actual ball. And we can start seeing what's going on when we move the center hue. So let's make it a little bit wider. Let's add a little bit nice roll off. Okay, so something like this. Okay, and let's see if we can make the selection nice and clean. Okay, and by nice and clean, I mean something like this. Let's do clean black a little bit. No, actually clean white. Okay, all right, I think clean white doing nice job. Let's see if we don't have anything dancing. Okay, that looks perfect. So we got nice selection. Now we can start manipulating our image. So I'm going to add more saturation. Okay, and be sure to keep your eye on it. We don't want to be too crazy. And with the wheels, or simply with the hue, hold on, where is the hue? There we go. We can change the color of this ball to match our model. So once we start moving the hue, we can see things kind of start looking a little crazy, a little bit different. We can have this ball color of the garage door, but because it's naturally warm, it doesn't make any sense to kind of go otherwise. So what we can do, we can try to match her purse. Okay, like that looks good. Let's see before and after. Okay. And one thing we need to do to match this kind of red is to drop a little bit of luminance, of brightness in that red channel. So let's go to the costume and select Y. So this is going to be luminance. And you're going to see how it starts matching the purse. Okay, so that looks great. What we can do now is to do a little bit negative color boost so the ball looks even. Let's shake it again, before and after. So that looks really cool. We start getting into the zone. So now we have nice three colors going on. We have blue, we have yellow, and we have red. Now this is a proper way of coloring. So when you look at this image, everything pops up instantly. And this is a very good sign when you want to do more higher-end commercial or when you're on set actually shooting things. This is how you're supposed to do it. And I don't want to leave those things just as is. Now we can start really blending the look. So let's do a new node. And in this node, we can kind of start giving a little bit 70s vibe. So let's make our print a little bit warm. Okay, all together. We can also do a little bit red in the shadows, okay? Kind of like that, just a tiny bit. Let's not go too crazy. So this one I'm going to call look. Now, if we want to go more stylized, we can start crashing blacks. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to go down with the black, okay? Just like this. I'm going to put the point. And we can see how this point acts as a pivot. So let me show you again. I'm going to go back a little bit. I want to make dark a little bit darker in this node. Now we're going to do next node. And then the following node, I'm going to just put the point here as an anchor. And we're going to elevate everything. And we can see our shadows becoming very milky. This has recently been very popular look on Instagram. A lot of people kind of enjoy this stuff. I'm not too big fan of that, but sometimes it works. We can see what it does to hair. So it sort of makes everything washed up a little bit. You can do very same thing with the highlights. Let's have, let's say, a point here, and we can start bringing it down or up. You see how it's affecting everything? It makes everything looks a little bit weird and milky. Let me show you. So this is how it was before. And you can see it evens out image a little bit. And with this point as a pivot point, you can sort of control how much of that effect you want. Okay, so let's put something like that. And let's check it out before and after. So this is the image we have, and later it's really up to you what you want to do stylistically with that. You can continue working on it. For example, you can add more contrast, you can add film grain. Let me show you a really cool trick. Let's create a new node, and let's click Alt-Y. So that's... Unfortunately, sometimes resolve go crazy. Let me fix everything. They need to figure out how to organize those nodes a little bit better. Okay, let's see, like that. Okay. So this is R. Okay, there we go. So we split image into RGB, red, green, and blue. And we can start playing around with all that. We can go to sizing. We can go to node sizing. And by simply moving tilt and pan, we can create interesting effects. So if you want to really mimic like 70s or some kind of artifacts, this is very easy way of doing this. So let's go a little bit like that. Let's go in a green and let's see, like something like this. There we go. So like that looks great. And we kind of have a little bit vibes of the 70s. So thank you guys for watching. This is it for this tutorial. If you want to learn more about the color theory, check my oldest video. I explain how to use the little color wheel with examples. And if you don't want to, you don't want to, but I'm going to see you in the next video. Stay corona free and take care.